Continuing from where Dr. Alok just left us, I'm going to do this 2-minute activity. So like him, I believe in the power of stories. So I just want you guys to take 2 minutes, turn around, and interact with the person behind you. All you have to do is simply talk to them, or the person next to you. Yeah, simply talk to them about why you're here. What brought you on a Sunday afternoon to come and attend a TEDx event? Who you really are and what inspires you? Just 2 minutes, share your story with the person behind you. Okay guys, thank you so much. Before you fall in love with each other and decide to get married, I'm going to move on with my story. When I was growing up, I was very close to my grandparents. And it happens with all our grandmothers, our nannies and dadis, that at night, before you go to sleep, you listen to a story. My nani used to tell me stories. Came from Pakistan, settled here, settled in Punjab, and made it big. Those stories influenced my life. Those are the stories that I could learn from, and they built my perception about who I am, who my family is, why are we here? What does my city look like? What does my country look like? And what do I owe it to the world? Then school started and my trips to my grandparents' house reduced, and so the stories reduced. So the stories faded away. And what took them over was textbooks. So while I was in school, I started focusing on being a typical nerd. So instead of listening to stories or instead of talking to people, I would stick and restrict myself to only my textbooks. So I knew everything about climate change, I knew everything about global warming, but I didn't know about what was happening outside, or I didn't know about the people around me. In class 10, when you have to take a decision about what to do next in life, I was very confused. I did well academically, so my dad said, take up science with bio. I also had this childish dream of curing cancer and becoming a doctor, so I said, let's jump into it, let's do science. 1 week later, I realized that that wasn't for me. So then I came back home and I was upset, obviously, right? Because you've done well, you've always scored well, and then you realize that you're not good at something. How does that make you feel? So I went to my father and I said that I can't do this. He said, okay, drop bio, take eco, because then you can still become an engineer. So I dropped biology, I took up economics, and I started preparing for the Fiji entrance exam, like most of you here. 2 months into that, I realized that this wasn't for me either. So I go back home with a morbid face, and then I approach my dad, and I say that, I can't do this. Ye ho hi nahi raha mujhse. I won't be able to do it. So then my dad and mom are having intense discussions that she'll never be able to do anything in life. She's giving up. Iska to kuch hoega hi nahi. And then they decide, okay, if you're not being able to do this, switch to commerce, because then you still have an option of being a chartered accountant. So I said, okay, this sounds fair. And you know, you're this 17-year-old person, you really want to make your parents proud, right? Like, that's one goal that I think we all share. So I decided, okay, let's take commerce and I'm going to nail this. And I did. I did really, really well in class 11 and 12. I aced my board exams, got 96%, and ended up doing BCom honors in Venkateshwara College in Delhi University. Now, in my class of 240 people, 180 were doing CA. Along with BCom honors. The rest were studying for CAT, because if not CA, then MBA is the only option that's left behind. So I started thinking, okay, should I be doing this? Because everybody else is doing it. My teacher said that, you know, you're good at accounts, take this up. My parents said, if not this, kuch hoega hi nahi. You won't be able to do anything in life. So you need to do this. I started studying for my first CA exam. 10 days later, I realized that this wasn't for me either. And now I decide to have this conversation with my parents again. By the way, my dad is a topper from SRCC, a qualified chartered accountant, running his business, a typical business family where the daughter either takes on the family business or goes on to achieve something like really, really big in life. So all he did was look at my mom and she said, "Tune bigada hai." So in the whole blame game, and I'm saying it very casually right now, but it was a very, very bad phase for me personally, because being an achiever in school, you know, always topping exams, doing well, I suddenly realized that I'm not good at anything. Mujhse ho hi nahi raha. I can't do science, I can't do bio, I can't do eco, I don't want to become an engineer, I can't do CA, what am I going to do in life? At this stage in life, I was very, very confused. I didn't know where I was headed next. I couldn't go back to my parents because I was ashamed of myself. So I started some introspection and I started watching videos again. Videos of people who had made it big in life. People like Steve Jobs, scientists, artists, people doing well in film, theater, and those became my mentors. I started learning from these stories. So the connection that I had with stories 16 years back, which my grandmother instilled in me, now suddenly came back. So I said, okay, so what really is the problem? Let me get to the bottom of this. I started talking to people in my college and I realized that those 180 people that were doing CA were not doing it because they liked it. They were not doing it because it was their passion. They were doing it because someone told them to. Whether it was a teacher, whether it was a parent, whether it was a friend, whether it was a career aptitude test taken back 5 years ago, which only gives you 3 options. But they were doing it because someone told them to. And it's not an easy mindset to change, right? Because job security, growth, money, high salaries, campus placements, it's alluring. You can't just give that up. So I said, how do I shift this mindset? How do I tell people to start believing in who they are and what they want to do and start chasing their passion? That's when I connected stories. So I organized a conference where I got people from different backgrounds, something similar. So whether it was a scientist, an artist, someone from theater, stand-up comedian, an entrepreneur, and I simply asked them to share their story. 300 people attended this conference. And much to my surprise, 3 months later, I kept getting mails from people. Mails from people from Shriram College of Commerce who had switched and, you know, decided to drop out of college and started companies. Mails from 2 people who had just met at the event and started something together. Mails from someone who had realized that software engineering is not my thing. I should take a gap year and get into the creative space. And people had started chasing their passion. As a generation, we talk about technology, we talk about artificial intelligence, we talk about shaping the future, we talk about moving humankind forward. But what is dehumanizing is our education system. Our education system instills in us this stereotypical way of just thinking in one direction. Whether if you take science, you can be a doctor. If you don't do that, you can become an engineer. Then you can become an accountant. But it doesn't teach us or it doesn't expose us to new things. So what I realized that in the generation that we belong, in the age group of 16 to 25, the problem is not education, because I am well educated. I went to one of the best schools in India. I went to Shriram School. A lot of my friends were educated. Everybody in college was educated, but they lacked exposure. Exposure to the right kind of people, the right kind of ideas, the right kind of opportunities, the right kind of things. And that's where I started bridging the gap. I created this company called Josh Talks, Josh literally to instill the drive in you to become successful. And over the last 2 years, I've been doing conferences across the country. You know, yesterday was our 20th edition in Pune, and we've held such conferences in over 9 cities, covering both tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 cities, where we call speakers from all sorts of backgrounds, whether it's a 23-year-old on a mission to end hunger in India, to the daughter of a sex worker who wants to become a drummer, to Anurag Kashyap who says that nobody owes you anything. We bring these stories to people like you and me to expose us to the possibilities of doing well. My goal in life is to revive the art of storytelling. Where we came from the caveman age, everybody used to weave stories. If you all remember, people used to sit around a bonfire at night and share things. And those are the things that decided who we would become. Those are the things that decided our future, they shaped how we thought about the world. But somehow, this art is getting lost. So the reason behind my talk and the reason behind doing this activity was for all of you to share your story so that something you take back from another person can change your life forever, like it did for me. Thank you.